afternoon sa inyong lahat at welcome sa ating 9th episode ng Nutrition and Health Webinar Series brought to you by Farmacia Jimenez. Sa episode natin ito, muli nating pag-uusapan ang how to maintain an active life during quarantine. Pero ang mga bida this time, yung mga tinatawag nating Zillennials. Ang Zillennial generation ay pinaghalang Generation Z at Millennials na sa ating estimate may age na 16 years old hanggang 38 years old. This webinar series is a community service brought to you by Farmacia Jimenez Corporation with our today's sponsors, Cell Life Cellular Nutrition at Oranim Thera Mouthwash. I am Grace. I'm going to be with you for the rest of the hour of this afternoon's episode. Sa mga nakakapanood po o nakapanood ng episode 6, napag-usapan natin ulit ngayon ang importance ng physical activities at exercise to stay fit at palakasin ang ating katawan, both physically at ang immune system natin. But this time, ang focus naman natin, yung mga teens at yung mga young professionals na nasasakupan ng Generation Z at ng mga millennials. Sila yung mga na-confine sa mga bahay nila during this time of quarantine. Yung mga dating busy, mga dating active, at saka yung mga tinatawag na mga social beings. Pero ngayon, nakatigil lang sila sa kanilang bahay. And to be exact, 5 months na tayo na puro nasa bahay lang, mobile phones, computer lang ang pinagkakaabalahan. Ano kaya yung mga physical activities na pwede nilang gawin nitong mga Zillennials na to? Yung mga indoor or some cases, may pwede na rin mag-outdoor para naman maging active sila ulit. At hindi sila magkaroon ng sakit at hindi rin sila maging bored. In this afternoon's episode, we are so privileged and so blessed to have our speaker guest who is also a very, who's physically active. He is a doctor of medicine and orthopedic surgeon. He is a fellow of the Philippine Orthopedic Association. He is a professor also in the La Salle Health Sciences Institute, an athlete and a father to two wonderful children. Welcome po, Dr. Tiger Garrido.
Hi, good afternoon. Good afternoon, guys. Thank you. Thank you for having me.
Thank you, Doctor. Actually, we are live on FB and YouTube. So, nanonood yung mga estudyante ni Doctor from La Salle Dasmariñas College of Medicine.
Patay. Oh, no.
Saka yung mga triathlete members ng Team Dugong, Hi Coach Pat and Team Dugong's and Jumpstart Tri. Hi, Lani. We have also invited two good-looking gentlemen as well. Okay, katulad ni Dr. Garrido.
They will Akala ko, hindi ako kasama sa good-looking eh. Grace naman eh. Magtatampo na ako eh.
Equally good-looking men. Who will also share their active life during this time of quarantine. Our first guest is a 25-year-old licensed commercial pilot who is also a graduate of De La Salle University in Manila, Bachelor of Science in Electronics and Communications Engineering. He is also the CEO and founder of Stream Global Services, a triathlete, a team member of Army Navy. Good afternoon. Shall I call you Captain Brian Yang?
Hello. Good afternoon, Miss Grace. And good afternoon, everyone. Thank you so much for inviting me here, and I'm so excited to share my experiences with you guys.
Thank you. So, yung susunod natin guest is also a very exciting guest. Of course, he's known to many of the mga basketball enthusiasts. He is actually a 26-year-old professional and collegiate basketball player. He was the shooting guard of Mapua Cardinals NCAA season 93 and 94 and is currently the shooting guard of San Juan Knights, a newly, shall I say, wed player and a father of one. Good afternoon, Mr. Cedric Pelayo.
Hello po, Miss Grace. Good afternoon to everyone. Hello po. Thank you for having me. It's a pleasure. Thank you po.
Thank you. Thank you, Cedric. Thank you, Dr. Tiger. Thank you, Brian. Dahil napapanood tayo via live stream sa ating mga Facebook Live at YouTube Live viewers ngayon, you can post your comments below at ang ating subject matter expert will try to answer some of your questions. Ulit po, in-encourage po namin kayong lahat to put your comments down below para sa mga susunod nating episodes, sa mga susunod nating webinars. In-encourage din po namin kayong mag-participate sa quick survey kung ang topic na to is useful and you find it relevant. Kindly po put yes and if not, kindly put no. At ang bonus po natin sa mga nanonood sa atin this afternoon, yung mag-actively participate at mapipili po yung question nila, you will have actually a chance to win the special gift pack from Cellife Cellular Nutrition at Oranim Terra Mouthwash. Pag napili po yung inyong comment or your question ngayong afternoon na to. Okay, Doc Tiger, umpisahan na natin. Ano po ba ang importance ng physical exercise or physical activity sa ating katawan, most especially dyan sa ating mga guests at sa mga nakikinig ng mga tinatawag nating zillennials, young professionals? At ano kaya yung possible consequence pag wala sila nito?
Well, I mean, for any age bracket naman, importante yung exercise technically, you know. But if we're talking about, you know, syempre yung age group na to na kasama, sige, sasama ko na yung sarili ko sa age group na yan, no, kahit 42 na ako. No, kasi you have to also consider these are very energetic and people that, you know, they go out every day. They're also, you know, the people that like to hang out, you know, and you know, the nightlife. And so there's a lot of not just physical things that you have to consider, but also some mental stuff na rin, no? Like trying to keep people who are with lots of energy in, you know, there's things like getting cabin fever and all of that. So that's why exercise would be an amazing way to parang let out some form of frustrations, you know, that extra energy as well, no? So for this age bracket, I guess that's one of the things that's really important with maintaining your exercise throughout the ano parang, throughout the quarantine. Yeah.
So, Dr. Tiger, share mo sa amin yung story mo with yourself, di ba? Tapos,
sure. Yung
recommendation dun sa ating guest.
Yeah. Definitely, pilot. Definitely.
Thank you.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Would you like me to do that right now? Okay, okay. So, just before we start, yeah, here we go. Let me get into this really quick. No? So, what this is technically, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to talk about like how I developed into like an athlete, parang ganun, just a bit of a parang background lang, no? There were a couple of questions that were given to me that, you know, I want to answer through, instead of just going, you know, reading something from a journal or a book, I'd like to share things to you guys through certain experiences that I've had throughout the years, no? So, of course, you know, active life during quarantine. So, I'm Dr. Tiger Garrido, right? So, I'm just going to go through my credentials really quick because Grace already gave it. I am a fellow in Philippine Orthopedics Association. I'm a diplomate of the Board of Orthopedics. I have a fellowship in adult hip and knee reconstructive surgery. So, that's really my thing, no? The hip and knee. I teach trauma as well. And I teach anatomy, so if my students are there, I hope you're listening. May quiz tayo mamaya pagkatapos nito. Okay? But, you know, other than that, you know, we always try to keep a well-rounded personality. So the other things I do, you know, I am a athlete. So this is not the best position that I've ever been in. But, you know, we learn from our failures. I used to play, but not anymore. I don't have the energy that these guys have right now to work and stay up as well. Huh? I do a lot of charity work. I've been doing it since I finished my orthopedics training. And of all the credentials, my favorite is being a father to two beautiful girls. Okay. So I'll just give you a little background of what I was doing from the age of 8 to the teens, which might include some of the people here. I was actually playing a lot of sports. I was so much into sports. I was playing tennis. I was competing as an age grouper. I'm sorry. Let me just go back to that really quick. Sorry. I was playing all of these sports almost at the same time. But I took out the other two because it just wasn't my thing as I was growing up. No. So you'll understand what I'm getting to later on. No? So Mondays, Wednesdays, Fridays, we were training for basketball. Tuesdays, Thursdays, Saturdays, we had volleyball training for LaSalle. I'm from LaSalle Zobel, and then I also played for LaSalle Taft. And then on weekends, that's when I would train for tennis. No? So from the age of 8 up to your teens, that's like unlimited energy. Yeah? Right? And you don't really consider what you're going to try to eat later on, because usually after training or after a game, what do I have? I'll probably have like a huge bowl of sinigang. You know, it's lunchtime right now, so I'm getting a little hungry. No, adobo with like, I mean, I don't know if you guys ever did this when you guys were like training when you were younger, maybe a couple of pieces of meat, but then like 3 cups of rice. You know what I mean? So if not, there were burgers, there were pizzas, and I never let any meal pass without having, you know, dessert, ice cream, cookies, you know, chocolates. But it didn't matter. I mean, even like, I guess with your age right now, it still doesn't, because I could eat all of this and, you know, this would still be me when I was younger. That's me with my parents over there. I don't know if, can you see me in this picture? I'm that skinny dude all the way there that could eat like a whole pizza. Metabolism was crazy when we were younger. And this is just before I went into med school. No, so you know, we were still fit. I was still playing for UAP and Taft just before this one. No. Okay. So then I hit my 20s to 30s. So it became I was in med school already by this time. I was in La Salle, Cavite. Now, what happened after that was, you know, bad. We had started to develop really bad habits. I mean, because we were up for 24 hours straight. So this is what I did when I was awake. If I wasn't working, I'd be eating, or I'd be eating, or I'd be sleeping, trying to study. No. So, you know, got to a point where when you're younger, you have all these good, I mean, metabolism, but then later on when that happened, so this was me just going into med school, and this is me a couple years later. You know, it looks like I got shorter. Can you, right? Cedric's like, he has to go really close to the computer to figure out which is me. That's me in the striped shirt. You know, I look a little chunkier and everything. So yeah, that's me right there. I mean, it's a huge difference from just changing the way I ate and not exercising at all. You know, that it does take a toll on you eventually, you know? So this is me. All right. This is me getting a little chunky already. And ano, yan o, o pansinin natin yung, you know, yung chin o, yan. Diba? I didn't have that before in the other pictures. So really, I know, because in my family, we're prone to, you know, getting a little bigger. So this is me. Oh, let's go really fast. I got married because when I was in residency, no? From being like this, you know, like the triangular where you have broad shoulders and a slim waist, you know? And then when you see that picture, it just went the other way around. Diamond shaped, na, di ba? So it gets... No, I mean, the reason why I mentioned like some how it's also like mental as well, because like getting locked down and not being able to exercise for someone that has a lot of energy is, you know, it's torture as well. No, it's not just something physical, but it's also something mental, Naren. Right? By the way, if you guys want to say anything or ask me anything while I'm talking, it's really okay. This isn't, you know, this isn't the formal lecture that I'm giving. Okay. So what did I do? I got introduced to this sport actually. So here I am again, just trying to lose weight. So I got into a sport that I kind of got into it again. You know, every time I, I get into a sport, I try to go all in, like even diets and stuff. So that was me, or I started losing weight. That was me. That's me on the left again. See, I was like, okay, I was dropping, you know, the chins were going, you know, it wasn't as floppy anymore. I was getting good at it. You know, I was getting pictures and, you know, yeah, don't mind that guy in red over there. I don't know if Cedric's ever played against him. Yeah, I kick his butt in this sport. No, we were teammates before. So, and then it got to a point where I, you know, how did I do it? I had to go back to eating like almost tasteless chicken. I'm really not good with my diet. You know, hard boiled eggs. This, I don't know if you guys are big salad fans. I just couldn't eat salads back then. It's not something I could do. And this and that, out. It was out. That's the only way I could lose weight. And that's 20s and 30s already, you know. Well, mostly part of the 30s. And then, you know, but I was lucky enough to be, you know, this is part of the first national team I played for about like 4 years. And during those 4 years, I was able to maintain, you know, the diet and everything. I mean, which is completely different, the diet and exercise. Because back then, if you want to go out and exercise, you can go out and exercise. You can do anything you want. Right now, it's completely limited. No, you're limited to the space. You know, the gyms aren't open anymore. So it becomes a little bit more difficult. Now, what happened when I started playing? Injuries. I tore during one of the trainings. I tore a ligament in my ankle. I tore both of my MCLs. I don't know if you guys said, do you have like any injuries? No, nothing yet. Are you still good?
I've had a Jones fracture on my foot before during NCAA.
Did they put a screw in it, or did they just put a cast in it?
We did a PRP.
Yeah,
PRP, air cast.
Yeah, an air cast. And how are you now? You're okay?
I'm better now, but sometimes I think mentally it like, yeah, think about it sometimes.
Right. There is that mental aspect about. Now, the reason why I also have a partially torn ACL on my right knee. I have dislocated my shoulder. I dislocated my shoulder during a tournament in Shanghai. And this is me getting an MRI for all of them and confirming that I actually do have all these injuries. And when you go back to it, what was different was because when I was in my, you know, from 8 years old to my teens, you know, I think my body was a little bit stronger. But when I hit my 20s and 30s, you know, all these bad habits, I'm not sleeping properly and everything, not getting enough time to recover before, you know, the next practices or the next game. So a lot of it becomes, you know, how you recover, which is, you know, nutrition is a huge part of recovery as well. Now that people are beginning, well, not just beginning, but understand already. And it's actually, it's how you teach the coaches, you know, the athletes on how to take care of themselves is, you know, that's the thing that has to be done right now. Now, so what happened next? So I was injured in all sorts of places. Then I just fell back in excuses. It's just all excuses. I couldn't do this. I couldn't do that. You know, the second I became a full-fledged orthopedic surgeon and hip and knee surgeon, I just said, you know, it's just all work. You know, if I had like, I do a lot of charity stuff. This was in Tacloban. I said, oh, I can't exercise and I can't eat properly because there's no food there. So we're stuck with, you know, we're stuck with canned goods. This was in Marawi. I have no choice to, you know, but whatever they feed me, that's what I'm going to eat. You know, I can't choose. Like if you look at the thing there are no vegetables there. It's like probably like 10 pots of rice and some, you know, some chicken and stuff like that. I mean, and if you see over there on, you know, on the picture on the left, I'm, you know, just getting a little chunky already, you know, all these reasons not to be healthy. Or like when I'm teaching, this is my class of like 300 students. It takes me forever to make lectures or, you know, I have 4 hour lectures. Sometimes I just, I have to go for the quick meal just so I can make a lecture and or something like just even for this one, you know, for such a short thing, it takes me forever. So, and the, you know, I have this hobby, and I love music and stuff like that. I love playing. So I turned a hobby of mine into something I could make money for, money with, because, you know, when, as a new doctor, you really don't make that much money. So, and I had a kid already. So I had to supplement my income by doing this. Problem is I learned vices. Like, if you see in the middle, you know, there's a drink and stuff like that. You could pretty much, like, you know, just hook me up to an Ivy line of Johnny Walker or something like that. And, you know, all of that plus staying out late because you have gigs late at night or till early in the morning, that doesn't really help with, you know, then you start eating just before you get home at midnight and stuff like that, or in the morning. So it gets a little tough, you know? And then what happened? So one day I was in clinic, and then one of the older doctors looked at me and was like, Tiger, are you okay? And, like, my eyes were red, I looked tired, and I had not really slept good for 3 days because of all the work. And physically, what happened was I developed hypertension, and I was still in my 30s when this happened. I was 170 over 110. That was good enough for me to be admitted into a hospital. You know, cholesterol up, liver function, you know, liver enzymes up, creatinine up. My blood sugar was up. It's like I had everything already, you know. It's as if I was like a 60, 65 year old guy that never took care of himself. And the worst thing about it, well, of course, this is, you know, this is bad, but, you know, some things are, when you look at, you see this and you're like, oh my God, you know, you get a little, it's not just because, you know, the lab tests, you can look at it and then put it away and then you might not feel bad about it. But sometimes when you see yourself in the mirror and it's like this, you know, the only thing I could do with this was make fun of myself, was to do this, you know, probably put a nose there, put some eyebrows, put a mustache, and it looks like a guy who's whistling. Because, you know, that's the only thing I could see when I see this. I just let go, you know, and with all of this cholesterol, liver function, you know, it's really bad. Other effects. Insomnia. So, I mean, one of the things that we have to realize, especially as athletes, is our body secretes like growth hormones during the nighttime, which allows us to recover better. That's why they always say you really have to have a good night's sleep. And that's why some people that have like these graveyard shifts don't recover so well, because in the time they're supposed to be recovering, they're awake, you know. Binge eating, you know, I try to not eat then, but I get really hungry. I tried all these fad diets, and I actually even considered, you know, doing surgery, because I had friends that said, oh, do you want to get rid of all of that really quick? Oh yeah, we'll do that. We'll do some sculpting as well. So, I mean, once you fall in deep into this, you know, so what happened next was, it was a good thing that, you know, my daughters are swimmers, right? And so the coach was like, okay, we're going to have a Christmas thing. Everyone, even the dads, have to swim. So the pool we have is like a 25 meter pool. By the time I get from one side to the other, I need to take a 5 minute rest before I try to go back. I couldn't breathe. I just didn't really. So one day I was just at the pool, just trying to swim, just to prepare for that. It was a good thing. You know, mine and Grace's coach was there. He was like, and he's a long time. He's a good friend of mine from high school. He's like, hey, Tigers, come on, let me get you swimming. Let me teach you how to do it properly and everything. So it was like an eye opener for me. But I mean, you'll see later on that, you know, like, well, first I got really addicted to it. I was swimming almost every day, and I'd wake up at 4:30. I get so obsessed that, you know, I'd be at the pool by 5 just to clean my lane so I can swim already. And that's not a fake picture, because I do it again. And then, you know, I still try to clean my lane just so I can swim already. I got really obsessed with it. But, you know, coach gave me the talk. You know, I am a doctor, but it doesn't mean I know everything. And then what did we talk about? We talked about concepts, you know, which is number one, nutrition. Okay. Number two, hydration. Number three, training. Number four, the injuries that you have. And number five, grit. So this, you know, we try to put all of these things together, you know, and how to develop yourself and how to maintain yourself and how to keep yourself from being injured. And actually, even if you want to, I mean, me and my coach, we have like these talks after training and when it's just me and him. And, you know, it took us like a long time for us to put everything together, despite the fact that he's a coach and I'm an orthopedic surgeon. I'm a doctor already. Because you really have to get, you know, you have to understand how it all affects your body, and you have to be willing to make those changes once you do understand what it means, you know? But for the sake of this conversation, we're just going to go into training and nutrition, because that's something, I mean, we have to talk about right now. So this was me. They tried to get me to do my first aquathlon. I tried to inhale as much as I can, but you know, gut was still sticking out. He didn't want to come in. This was the first time I tried to do it was a triathlon, but I was only doing the swim portion. I had the nerve to carbo load the day before, even if I didn't need to. It's bad, just bad eating habits. This was me coming out of the water. Grace showed me a picture that she said she was going to show where they just decided to put abs in me so I don't look so bad in my picture. But because of my amazing teammates, we actually did win third place against some young guns, but not through me by any means. I had to take a picture of myself to make sure I knew, you know, what was happening to me. And then, you know, because getting from that to this, because it's different when you see if you're improving or not. It's different when, I mean, because labs don't make sense, and the food that you eat, sometimes you can't keep track of it. But because we had all these concepts together of nutrition and exercise, I was able to join my first Gran Fondo. It's just that I was not prepared, even with the nutrition that I had tried practicing of biking for like 130, 140 kilometers, because I ended up getting cramps and them giving me my finishing medal in the emergency room. I was completely dehydrated. My blood pressure was 80 over 60. I was cramping all the way there. So they gave it to me in the ER. That was the first time they've ever seen that happen either, you know, so I just had to cry that one off. Because of that, I was able to join like a swim junkie where I swam 6 kilometers, actually, you know, just trying to make sure that I want to follow these concepts already. And plus, you know, having all those diseases and having kids, it changes. I mean, you know, like said, you have a kid, right? So you're so tuned in to making sure you're healthy to make sure you see your kids get older. You know, so there was a lot more at stake for me than just the exercise and the diet as well. I was able to be part of the first triathlon that they had held in New Clark City. In February, I ran my first full marathon. And I could not have done this without having the knowledge about, like, you know, my diet. It was such a huge thing, because you have to figure out when you're going to eat, when you're going to take salts. You know, I mean, I'll try to apply it to the topic, but I'm just going like a couple of steps ahead, so you see like the extremes of it, that if you don't follow it, you know, you're gonna like cramp up like me and end up in the emergency room. So ano ngayon, diba? So what if I told you guys about everything that happened? What happened to me was, you remember this part where I told you I was hypertensive? You know, I just had the labs of an old man. I got a stress test and tested everything right after that. And what happened after that was, went down to normal. My cholesterol was normal. Liver function was normal. Kidney function was normal. Blood sugar is normal. So if you're going to ask me what could happen if you don't exercise during this, like from March, April, May, June, July, August, like 6, and even a couple more months, for 6 months, you could be on the right side where it says 120 over 80 and normal, and shift to the left side. Right? You know what I mean? Whereas if you were on the left side and you decide like, hey, maybe I have time for myself because I'm on quarantine, I can exercise, I can watch what I eat, you can go from the left side to the right side. I mean, it could happen anyway, even if you're in your 20s. I have friends that have been on maintenance drugs since they were you know, in their late 20s and early 30s. So, you know, age right now isn't really the main determinant if you're going to be on any of these medications. So is this the end? Probably not. Now we're going back to exercise. Why is it important? We all know that after exercising, after a game set or after a race, right, you're tired, but you're so pumped up right after, right? That's that physical wellness that you're looking for. And also that mental wellness that we also need. I mean, like, you know, there's also this clarity of mind that you have after, you know, after practice and after training, you know what I mean? Especially if your training involves you running a couple, like maybe 10, 15 kilometers, the only thing you're doing is you're actually doing a lot of mental training, because it's not about your legs anymore. It's about how long you can actually stay on. And of course, you know, it follows that physical, mental, and emotional wellness, right? So important. That's the importance of exercise. But if you look up there, if we change exercise, we take that out and then we put in nutrition, you still get the same answers, right? You're still going to get physical wellness. You're still going to get mental wellness. You're still going to get emotional wellness. The reason for that, because the way I see it, is that nutrition and exercise is, you know, they're tied together. You can't really have one without the other, you know, especially like, for example, for Brian Cedric, who are at a higher level or even the highest level of exercise. I mean, both of them, you can't do without the other, without proper nutrition and proper exercise and training. So, I mean, going back to this, like with injuries, you have to also put illness, you know, you realize that they still all tie in together. Now, when we're training, right, when we're training, and then, which means like when we're exercising, right, what happens? We sweat, we burn a lot of energy, and we have all these micro tears with our muscles. That's how we actually get stronger. So now we have to go back to nutrition and fluid. So we're sweating, right? So what do you need? You need to hydrate. You need your electrolytes. I mean, that's why we cramp up, you know, because we don't have those electrolytes to help keep the muscles going. We're burning energy. If you don't eat your carbs, I mean, I used to remember it was just chicken and hard boiled eggs. And everyone said that carbs was the devil, you know? Well, when I was growing up, oh, if you want to lose weight, don't eat carbs at all. Don't eat bread. Don't eat, you know, rice. And then you realize later on that you actually do need the carbohydrates, because with these micro tears, in order for you to get you need your proteins to rebuild. If you don't have the energy to rebuild, then that means your recovery is a lot longer than anyone else. So like, let's say if Sed's having a long season, if he's not getting enough carbohydrates in order for him, for his proteins to, you know, for his body to help rebuild, by the time he gets into the finals, the people that have been rebuilding their muscles are going to be a little bit fresher than him. So that makes it an advantage for the other people that are actually following a good, you know, a nutritional program. So it doesn't, or like, for example, like me and competing against Brian, who's, you know, who he can call me Tito already, right? So if I don't get enough carbs and proteins in my training, even if I could maybe run as fast as he can in training, or bike as fast, or swim as hard as he can in training, but when the race comes there and I have not built myself as well as he can, then there's no way I'm going to win. You know what I mean? So sometimes then we get into supplementation. So it becomes a part of it. It's a little far off from what we have to do during quarantine, but as athletes, you know, it comes into question sometimes, why do we need supplementation? Sometimes you don't get enough of the macros and the micros that you need from your diet. You know what I mean? You're on a specific diet for some people that are trying to lose weight. Sometimes, you know, they go into keto, plant-based, or they don't have enough meats because they're vegan. A specific training program, like Brian might have a 42 kilometer race that he's training for. So he runs a long distance on Saturday, but he's expected to do a bike race on Sunday. So he has to load up some, you know, it's not something, it's probably something he can do because he's younger, but someone who's probably older might not, you know, or some people that plateau, you know, they have to supplement their exercise with it, with some form of like, you know, well, supplementation. Now, if you were to be asked, right, you know, if, since we're getting into it, if you were given something that has high protein and nutrient density, of course you'd say yes, right? Yeah, I want that because it's something I need for training, right? And it's also because, like, when we try to get a full meal, like let's say any of our micros, we have to eat the whole thing in order to get it. And sometimes it includes some fat that we don't need anymore, you know, or some excess, you know, meats that we don't really need anymore. So if this is high protein already and it's dense in nutrients, of course you're going to say, yes, I would like to have some of that. If it's plant-based, then it makes it a lot easier for people to accept, especially those that are on certain diets that they don't want to load up too much on meats, especially like people that have uric acid or gout, you know, so they'd rather go for something like this if it's sustainable and affordable. I mean, that's one thing you consider when you're going out to the malls and you're looking for supplements. You know, you kind of try to compare brands and see which is, you know, which is more expensive, which is cheaper, but has the same effect as this one. You know, if it's sustainable and affordable, of course you'll say yes, you know, but if there's something that has, will give you 40 micros and 60% protein, why not, right? You'd go for it. And if it has an antioxidant, of course, why not? Well, the antioxidants that you need, because it's during the process of repair, you know, when you're breathing in the oxygen actually becomes a little bit toxic to your body. You need the antioxidants for it, right? So, you know, I'm just going to do a shameless plug. The reason why I brought it up was because it actually does exist, you know? And I have to apologize because I've never tried it before, because I'm kind of late into the game already of, you know, supplementation and, you know, my age. I wasn't so sure if I really wanted to compete or if I just wanted to finish things. But now that I do, you know, I'm definitely going to try it out, because why not? When you look at the things on the left, why not? You know what I mean? And yeah, I guess that's it. And huling hear it, you know, just a little advice for people that are in groups, you know, like when you're all together. Didn't you notice that right after practice, it's like your mouth is kind of dry, you know, you don't exactly have, you know, the breath, or like, you know, my class, you know, when they're like, Dr. Garrido has been teaching for 4 hours already, we haven't had any water, my mouth is dry. Or like when during training, there's like cake on the pool, you know, and we want to eat already, or, you know, there's donuts in the pool. Of course, just make sure, another shameless plug, keep it smelling good, because nobody wants to talk to a winner, even when if he has bad breath. Okay, so the last thing I wanted you guys to see is, check this out, see who is that person all the way on the right who trains with us. That's Grace. So she's a bit of an idol for us, because she's done all of these amazing races that, I mean, you know, we're talking about like all of this supplementation and food and stuff like that. And she would, Bri, I don't know, but she might beat you on a triathlon at her age. I think she would. I would say so too. You know what I mean?
Actually, Doc, Ironman, super, diba?
Yeah.
We saw each other there. You both
did she have a better time than you? See, there you go. There you go. I don't even know why she asks me about certain things, but she'll come in and have better times than me anyways. Doesn't matter, no? Well, I mean, I hope this makes sense to you guys. I mean, like, you know, if I were to be asked what is the importance of exercise, I showed you guys. If you don't exercise, I mean, you have you could fall into a hole where, you know, you could be unhealthy. If you don't exercise, what could happen if you do exercise? You could maintain your health, and you can actually, some people still train and, you know, they'll come back, to the season even stronger. No. And what do I advise people? Well, in terms of exercise, it really depends on what you're into. If you're into group classes, then you can always attend like these HIIT classes, or if you're not into that, you could do yoga or if you have your own, you know, trainer at home or dumbbells or a treadmill. I mean, for me, I don't advise any specific thing for anybody. For me, it's just do something. It doesn't matter what it is. Just do something twice a week, three times a week. You know, sometimes I'm saying this, but I am also at fault for not doing it because of the COVID thing. And I'm going to go with the excuse again that I have so much to do. But, you know, the best thing is just really go for it. In terms of nutrition, I mean, we always know what's bad for us or not, you know, but we just go for it anyways. Just try to look out for yourselves, because you don't want to get to a point where you're going to have to try to exercise. And, you know, like what happened to me, where I'm exercising and I'm trying to eat properly because I got to the point where I could have been taking maintenance medications, which I don't right now anyways. Okay. So yeah, that's pretty much it that I wanted to share with you guys. I hope that didn't take too much of your time. Thank you. Madaming salamat.
Thank you, Dr. Tiger. You know, I didn't realize we have DJ Tiger in the house. Sabi nga niya, oh. I didn't realize. You know, Captain Brian, yeah. And we didn't realize we have DJ Tiger in the house. Hindi yung Dr. Tiger ang pumasok. The DJ Tiger, diba? All right. Sabi ng mga med student. What? Captain Brian, you were saying something?
Dapat may ano pala tayo, Miss Grace, no? May inuman tayo.
Oh, nga.
Inuman. Tapos, DJ Tiger.
Sige. Yeah, when we do, tapos we'll do recap for the ano, no? for the segment. Oh, why not? Why not?
It was succinctly delivered. Punong-puno. It was only yung iba lang nag-message sa akin, sabi ano daw, nosebleed.
Nosebleed ba? Ay, sorry.
I'm sorry. Hindi ko na sabihin si Dr. Tiger, but he felt like he's doing his lecture in class, and sabi ng mga med student ng Lasal.
And nandiyan sila?
Tiger, some of your students are watching Dr. Tiger.
Batay.
Agree, Captain Brian, and said, okay. Sige, buti na tayo. Doc, thank you.
We'll
ask you questions later.
Sure.
Captain Brian and said, share
yes,
their
by all
their
means, please. Yeah, yeah.
How they keep their activities tuloy-tuloy despite of the quarantine. Yeah. Yes, yep. Captain Brian, go ahead.
All right. So hello once again, everyone. And hello to all our viewers. Once again, I am Brian Young. So right now, I am currently here in my hometown. So I've been stuck here for 5 months already. So I am here in Iligan City, Mindanao. So I'd like to say hi also to all my friends who are watching and to my fellow streamers. So as of right now, what's keeping me busy is I actually set up my own business during this quarantine season, since we know that online way of working has been very prominent nowadays. So we've capitalized on that situation, and right now we're in partnership with a different Asian clients for our small-time na BPO na company. So what's keeping me busy right now is, of course, that one, my business. So actually, right now I just came from the graveyard shift, so I actually was monitoring some of my streamers there, some of my employees, and like what Doc Tiger said, it's really hard, diba? It's really hard to adjust when you're from the graveyard shift, and then it's different when you sleep when there's already sunlight, diba? It's so much different. So what I can say is I really made it a routine to work out every day, no matter what time it is. So si Doc Grace is a witness of that, because actually I met si Miss Grace. We were classmates, di ba, Miss Grace? We were classmates at Anytime Fitness.
Right, yeah.
So we actually met sa gym, and then yun. Siguro mga 40% gym, 60% puro chika lang. Oh, no, not me. Sorry. 20% workout, 80% chika lang, no? The 2 hours na nasa gym kami, siguro mga 1 hour, 20 minutes yun. Chikahan lang kami doon. With the other, ano, also, with the other people sa gym and their coaches. So, Miss Grace, I shared some photos with you, right?
Yeah, we have both to share. Yeah, in the video also.
Sige, sige. I'd like to share those photos lang. Pero I think the second photo is not mine. I don't have a baby yet.
And the video also is there.
Yeah, sige.
The Captain Brian, how to keep himself fit.
Yes, so let's show the video siguro later on towards the end, Miss Grace. So sige, let's go sa... photos.
But since now closed na ang mga gyms, diba? Restricted.
Yeah.
Not restricted but closed. Your video actually would show us what you do. That's inside your house.
Yeah, that's inside our house. So we actually have a treadmill here inside the house. So I try my best to utilize on our equipment. Although there are actually some gyms that are open here. Pero of course, I try my best not to go there because we have to make sure na we don't get contracted by the disease. Diba? So actually, this was the time before when we were still free to go out, to work out with our teammates. So right here, I'm with my teammates. So actually, I think the one who took this photo is si Coach Pat.
Coach Patrick Hoso.
Coach Pat, because he was biking with us and then he was like, oh, ang ganda ng view. Sige, picturean ko kayo. So, there. So, these are some of my teammates sa Army Navy. And then, if you can see, this is si Coach Betsy.
Yes, yes.
Great swimmer. Yeah, great swimmer. Really great swimmer. So, she's also my coach sa swimming. So, we do swimming lessons sa Vermosa.
Yes.
So, this was in Nuvali like a year ago. And this is me. Okay, sige, next. So I'm actually one of the Instagram boyfriends at team. If you can see, say let's go back there muna, Miss Grace. So this is si Coach Van Agdon Pinaytray. So she's also one of my our teammates and then Instagram influencer din to. So just telling me to sige kunan mo ako ng magandang picture. So this was the time when we were still free, di ba? So the one thing that I really miss the most during this, ano, this quarantine season is of course the water, di ba? I really miss swimming because actually, just to give you a little background, I've been a swimmer since I was in grade school. So like si ano, si Doc Tiger, I was also a Lasallian. So I was here in Lasall Academy sa Iligan City.
Go Lasall!
Yeah, go Lasall! And then actually, I tried also being a part of the varsity team sa TAF. Pero since I was ano, an engineering student, so it was really hard to juggle my ACADS and training. So I was like, ah, okay, let's stop this na lang. Sorry. All right, sige, next, Doc Gray. So this is me with my girlfriend, so si Isa Parcos. So she's actually watching right now.
Hi. Hello.
So this was our last race together. This was last March. March 8, I think. Vermosa, Aquathlon. Yeah, there. There, yeah. Were you there also, Doc? Oh, small world. Next time. And then this was me with my girlfriend and her dad, si Tito Toto. So actually, just a short background. I wasn't really into the triathlon scene before. And then it was the two of them who actually invited me way back 2016. Yeah, or 2017. Because they really wanted to try. And then actually, my first race, triathlon, was Ironman Cebu 70.3, which was still Cobra. That was Cobra Ironman before. So that was last year's Subic Ironman. We entered as a team, relay. And then, so that was when I saw si Miss Grace also. So she was really fast, di ba? Sinasabi lang niya na ano, na pagod na daw siya, walang training pero ang galing.
Cell Life, powered by Cell Life.
Yes, of course, with proper
nutrition,
di ba, and supplementation. So Miss Grace, I'll be waiting for my ano, ha, for my package.
Oh, sure.
Okay, sige. So what's next? So that was the last photo, no? So actually, I also shared one of my photos before. So during this quarantine season, what I can say is we really have to develop and stick to a healthy routine, di ba? So
a bit, little bit, roll it up, take a hit, feeling it, feeling right, 2 a.m. summer night, I don't care, hand on the wheel, driving drunk, I'm doing my thing, rolling the mix beside and now, living my life, getting out dreams, I'ma do just what I want, looking ahead, no turning back, people told me slow my roll, I'm screaming out, fuck that, I'm screaming out, fuck that, I'm screaming out, fuck that, fuck that, fuck that, fuck that, fuck that.
There.
Yung video, it's gonna play in a while, but I'm sure it's there.
Sige, yeah. Sige. It's only music, no video. So I think I can share my screen na lang, Miss Grace.
Go ahead. Uh-oh.
So I'd like to share to everyone lang my routine here in the house. So some of my workout sessions. So what I actually do is for everyone here, since di ba online teaching, online method of classes is already very rampant. So there are a lot of online exercises, di ba, online group workouts. So what I do is I watch those workouts, di ba? YouTube, or I enroll in some classes like bar 3 or yoga classes. So I try to look at those videos and then try to create my own workout. So what's different with me kasi is I really don't have a coach. So it's all on my own, based on research lang and some videos. So sige, I'll share to everyone na lang.
Yeah. Said we'd also share his later.
Third
one for him.
Yeah. All right, so I'll just prepare the video.
Yung house ni Captain Brian kinonvert niya into a gym.
Yung ano lang, yung study.
Grabe.
Yeah, he's got all. I mean, like he's got his treadmill there. He's got his weights there. Lahat kompleto. Show all them. Right.
So everyone can see na, no?
Yeah, we can see it.
Okay, so I'll be minimizing lang the... Okay, so... Ala, nawala yung music. Ah, there.
Hi.
Little bit, blowing it up, taking it, feeling it, feeling like 2 a.m. summer night. I don't care, hand on the wheel, driving drunk, I'm doing my thing, rolling the mist beside and out, living my life, getting out dreams. I'ma do just what I want, looking ahead, no turning back. People told me slow my roll, I'm screaming out, fuck that, I'm screaming out, fuck that, I'm screaming out, fuck that, fuck that, fuck that, fuck that, fuck that.
All right. Yan lang.
Walang chika, no? Maraming nagagawa.
That's inside your house, right?
Yes, that's inside the house. Actually, outside this room. So, here, I'll...
Yeah.
So, there. My treadmill's there. And some of my weights are there also.
Mm-hmm.
So, that's what I've been doing. Of course, with exercise comes proper nutrition and supplementation. Although, Like what si Doc Tiger said kanina, di ba? I don't know. Siguro I'm capitalizing since I'm still kind of young. So actually, honestly speaking, medyo YOLO ako when it comes to eating right now. So siguro mga 5 times a day. And then with desserts talaga yan. So exactly as what, ano, as what Doc Tiger said. And actually, it was really an eye-opener for me because, you know, we can't really rely on our age. And then even if we're really active, if you don't control what you eat, like let's say puro crispy pata or lechon kawali, and then isang rice cooker ng rice with durian and ice cream and cake. So, di ba, we really have to maintain proper nutrition, hydration, carbs and protein, di ba? Because we really need those. And then if you were seeing kanina, what's good here is, syempre, since I'm here in my house with my fam, not in Manila where I'm alone, libre yung food here. So that's the upside of being here. And of course, with proper supplementation also. So I really can't wait to receive my package from Miss Grace and then... Yeah. Of course, try it na, di ba? So there, for everyone listening, just try to stay clean and safe all the time, di ba? Try staying at home, just go out if really necessary, and then follow the proper COVID protocols, and then maintain a healthy lifestyle, develop a healthy active routine, and actually, just simply walking around the house or walking with your dogs, playing with your dogs, that's actually a really nice way of exercising already. And watch YouTube videos also, di ba? Mga workout sessions.
Yeah.
So there. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Captain Brian, you know, one thing I realized this afternoon, this is such a great combination of three active gentlemen. Di ba? Parang... You know, hearing from Dr. Tiger na akala mo it's really more on anatomy and physiology. Yung pala, nandun talaga yung importance of nutrition dun sa kwento niya. Evidence-based daw si Dr. or experience-based daw si Dr. Tiger. Kaya ang galing ng combination. Plus, of course, having another Lasallian in the house made it complete, di ba, Dr. Tiger? Yung sinabi mo. Anyway, of course, he's not a Lasallian. He's from Mapua Cardenas. Let's thank you, Captain Brian. Si Cedric naman ang mag-share for us. Ngayon, nung kanya mga activities.
Hello po, Miss Grace.
Thank you, Cedric.
Hello, Doc Tiger. Hello, Captain Brian. Hello to yung mga viewers dyan, yung mga fans ng MPBL, yung mga fans ng San Juan. Kamusta kayo dyan?
Nagtatagalog si Ced.
Opo. Konti lang.
Yes, so, Ced. Yes. Yeah, would you like to share ano yung mga physical activities that you do during this time of quarantine?
Opo. Well, as you guys know, tigil yung liga natin ng MPBL because of COVID and for safety reasons, which is right naman. So, for us as a team, when they stopped yung liga, nasa North Finals kami, Division Finals. So may Game 3 pa kami kalaban Makati. So we stopped that because of COVID during March. So what we do in the meantime, since technically we're going to resume the league as stated by the MPBL as the promise. These are some of our pictures during this past season. We still work out as a team. So before, earlier during the beginning of our ECQ, may mga Zoom workouts kami. I'm pretty sure halos lahat ng team, kahit sa PBA, kahit anong mga team, may mga Zoom team workouts. So, we started doing that, yung mga Zoom workouts. Pero, of course, as time went on, yung mga ibang teammates ko naging busy kasi kailangan natin magkayod or make money para sa family. So, medyo naging busy. So, instead of Zoom workouts na we just did parang our coaches sent us a workout regimen or workout plan that we need to follow for every day and only rest on Sunday. So it's like we're still in season now. We're practicing all halos every day, but it's almost not the same. But we try to keep our conditioning just in case whenever, you know, hopefully na natapos yung COVID, we can resume and started playing again. So we're still maintaining our healthy lifestyle, our conditioning by working out as a team and sending our videos para just in case we're always ready naman kasi we still have to finish this season. So dito yung mga pictures natin dito yung for this past season. As you can see, miss ko na yung basketball.
Idol.
thank you. So last season champion kami. So we were supposed to defend our championship this season, pero as you guys know, natigil. Pero if you guys watch MPBL or if you guys are fans of MPBL, yung mga games natin, if your last game medyo late masistart ma 8 or 9 p.m. yung last game. So it's really hard to, as Doc mentioned, yung nutrition, to keep up with your nutrition also, because since we're playing at a high level, right? So medyo late yung mga games natin, 9 p.m. sometimes will finish until 11 or 12. And as Doc mentioned, it's not healthy to have a heavy meal at midnight, right? It's not good for your health or your metabolism. So what I try to do is I use yung Cell Life, and I use it after our games when it's late because, you know, we don't have the time to eat and I need the nutrients and proteins and stuff like that Doc mentioned to have my body recovered so I'm ready just in case we have practice the next day or sometimes we travel to Cebu or Kaitan, sa Davao, pag may away game. So I really use Cell Life. It's very important for me na I need it because time is very limited for us and we need to recover and we need the energy. So it's very important for us. So during the quarantine, I'm fortunate enough. I don't know about yung ibang tao doon or yung mga ibang teammates ko. There's a court here sa roof deck natin. So may video ko dyan na we're with my teammates, si CJ Isip, na we're still trying to, you know, maintain our conditioning and having a well-balanced, healthy lifestyle. So it's right there. Let's go.
It's not showing. It's not showing. He's trying to share it, but it's not showing. Do you have your video? Ayan. Can you share it?
Yeah. Dito.
Yeah. Kasi Doc Tiger dun sa video.
Oh, yeah. So as you guys can see, we're very fortunate na may court dito sa roof deck natin. So we have a chance still to, you know, play basketball and practice what we love. Because I know yung mga ibang gyms, they're closed during sa quarantine, which is only right naman kasi we have safety first naman talaga. So we're very fortunate na may court kami dito. Now we get to practice still and not get too rusty, just in case.
You're too young to get rusty.
Exactly po.
Dr. Tiger, yung pinakita the video that
yes, ma'am.
Cedric showed, no? Because he's a basketball player. So we know you mentioned about grit earlier on during your presentation. So kung ganyan, I think the last Zoom that we had together with
Alex,
we were talking about
grit.
Yung grit. Yeah. What happened on grit in the absence of an outdoor training?
Okay, wait, hold on. If you want to talk, let me show you something. Do you see that thing in the back over there?
What's
can,
that?
Oh, can you see this? Yeah, yeah right there. Grit. Yeah, it says grit. Wait, hold on. Let me get it for you guys. Okay. Well, I knew the word before, but I don't know if it it's upside down.
It's a Lasallian word.
Yeah, right? It says grit. It has this one by.
It's Lasallian word, right, Dr. Dyke?
Definitely.
I'm Captain Brian.
So it's, diba? It's mental toughness, diba?
Yeah.
And courage, diba? Firmness, diba? Of mind. So actually, one of the things that we were talking about recently was that one of the things you can actually develop now, I mean, like, you know, it's great that SED has like the court to play in, because you can keep your drills as close to what you're being taught to do during practice, above. But another thing that would be good for us, or for anyone that in that matter, is to that grit in itself, is to develop that at this time. This is a perfect time to actually develop it. Because, I mean, like, if you can't play, like, let's say, for example, if you can't go out and play an actual game, I mean, how hard is it to just keep on training and training and training and training without a game, diba? Because you don't see that end in sight because you're just training. So that really develops a lot of mental toughness right now, you know, for a lot of people. I mean, since there are no races for Grace and Brian, all of us, so that thing that what are we working on is grit. That's the mental toughness. I'm trying to discipline yourself, even if you don't have any games or any races, like with your food, or even just trying to get back into exercising. That's how you develop grit, which I see that later on will translate when you're actually in a game, you know, like, for example, like, you know, overtime and everything, but you've already done that a million times during practice in your rooftop, diba? Or, you know, or you've ran that last couple kilometers on your treadmill already at home, that you could actually finish it, diba? So, I mean, that's one of those things that's great to develop right now, is not just the physical thing, but also the mental toughness, that, you know, people don't see it as an opportunity. They see it as they're stuck, when people could actually use it to develop, you know, grit, mental toughness, you know. Like, if you're not a real athlete, it's like, but how dedicated are you to becoming fit, at least? If you're a gym rat kind of person, how dedicated are you where when you get back to the gym, it's like you never really left, diba? And so, I mean, that's, I guess if that's what you're asking about grit, then I mean, that would be the perfect definition of it, especially right now. No, for me, I mean, that's how I would take it, diba? I'm sure, you know, you guys would feel the same way somehow, do you? Yeah.
Yeah. Mm. Sid, you're about to say something, Cedric.
Yeah, like what Doc Tiger was saying, you're totally correct about, you know, grit and mental toughness, especially during a time like this. Mm. Not a lot of people think it's important, but it is. Like, people get down or depressed. It just depends on how you look at it and how you're gonna switch that energy and try to push yourself towards a goal, like you said.
Yeah. Definitely. Said, can I just share something really quick? One of my really, really good friends, he's actually the head sports and physical therapy crew of the New York Knicks, Irwin Valencia. So we've been talking even until now, like even with basketball, that like just with the NBA just recently opening, that prior to that opening, you know, they really had to, you know, it was not just a struggle, but I mean, they really had to keep themselves, you know, healthy, and exactly what you guys are doing. They'll go out in their own gym and, you know, do their own training sessions. And because the second, like, for example, like if next week they say, okay, game na, pwede na tayo maglaro, you have to come go back in as if you never left left the game.
Exactly. Diba?
So, I, you know, that's something really important, I guess, that keep yourself, yeah. I know, yeah.
And of course, not just the training, you mentioned about also hydration and nutrition, of course. No?
Mm.
So that's exactly the reason why we're here. We're discussing it, because a lot of people, Tagalogin ko na pala, Dr. Tiger, nagagalit.
Hey, sorry.
Sabi niyo, nagtanong, good afternoon, Dr. Tiger, after ECQ, my ITBS recurred. When I stopped swimming, I feel it's getting worse every day. What advice can you give me to lessen the pain? I'm 52 years old, and he's also using Cell Life.
Ah, okay. Consulta na pala to. Sige lang. No. Well, de, ganito naman eh. Especially now na medyo hindi tayo nakakalabas talaga. I mean, yung mga activities natin medyo constrained. So, pagka ganyan, say 52 years old, yung ITBS, one of yung pwede natin gawin kasi dyan is hot compress, stretching exercises, and of course, you know, if we're going to go back to nutrition talaga, you have to make sure you have the, kailangan yung katawan natin may building blocks siya para makabuo ulit ng muscle. Kasi kung wala yun, useless lang, you know. Kasi yung ITBS, makukuha mo yan sa kakagalaw, kakatakbo. O usually long distance runners yung ITBS eh, parang mga ganun. Or laging nakatayo o parang ganun, no? So, syempre, bababaan mo yung intensity ng exercises mo. Tapos, magkoconcentrate ka sa other things such as recovery. Stretching exercises, hot compress, physical therapy, of course, yung nutrition mo. Kailangan talaga. No? Kailangan talaga balance talaga eh. Hindi pwedeng malakas ka pero wala kang flexibility in nutrition. Hindi pwedeng okay nga yung kain mo pero hindi ka naman nag-exercise. Kailangan talaga. Kailangan, and for parang sa bawat tao, iba-iba yung balance eh. Yung parang, so kailangan hahanap. Personal yan eh. Personal yan eh, na kung ako kaya ko tumakbo ng ganito tapos yung stretching. Pero ako kailangan ko mag-stretching ng 30 minutes. Diba? Baka kayo, hindi nyo kailangan ng ganun. Diba? Baka konting ganun-ganun lang, okay na kayo. Ako kasi mga 30 minutes kailangan ko mag-stretch pagkatapos. Kundi, pag-uwi ko sa bahay, parang, hindi ako makagalaw. Ganun ako eh. So, kailangan ko mag-stretch eh. So, yung balance talaga. Kailangan nyo siya hanapin. Otherwise, I mean, sa you can take medication kung kailangan, pero always stretch out. It's part of the discipline you should have as an athlete na mag-stretching or to work after working out, no?
Mm-hmm. I agree. It's always a balance between everything. Yan din yung sinabi ni Coach Patrick when he was arguing the last time. He was really saying that there should really be a balance between the two. Not just the two, but between all the things that you do. So I guess si Cedric is also agreeing with us kasi parang yung ganun ni Ced. Right, Cedric?
Opo, very important, very important. Opo.
So anyway, do we still have time to ask for another question? Dr. Tiger, kasi yun nga eh, yung iba kasi they do not believe in sports nutrition or yung nutrition for athletes. Kasi sinasabi nila it's just being marketed for the reason just to sell, no? So kanya-kanya silang beliefs. But we heard it from Cedric, we heard it from Captain Brian that they realized the importance of nutrition. And you yourself is an athlete and you know that for a fact, Dr. Tiger. So,
yes.
Bago ko tanungin sa'yo this next question. So, kung sinasabi mo nga, Dr. Tiger, na iba-iba yung requirements depends on the, you mentioned yourself na sabi mo, depende ako anong age group, depende ko anong physical activities. But you also mentioned that importante yung protein dun sa support nutrition natin, especially during recovery. And I think Cedric and Captain Brian would agree with me. So, do you really recommend, before I get this question, do you really recommend a specific brand or wala naman? Or you just say...
Me or all of us? Or...
Yeah, us.
You guys can go first. Okay lang. Brian. Yes, yeah. Sir. Yeah. Go ahead.
Now, si Cedric mentioned a while ago that he really takes time to, I think, recover by
supporting. Yeah. Saka I see his need na parang travel pa, tapos late game, tapos parang ganun. So, you really need it talaga. Well, ako personally, it really depends on your, number one, what are your goals? If your goal is just to make sure that you, kunwari, gusto mo lang pagpawisan 3 to 4 times a week, tapos medyo yung mabawasan yung maintenance meds mo, mga ganun, baka hindi mo kailangan mag-supplement. Parang ganun. Pero, kunwari, kung yung goal mo is to get stronger, di ba? Or to bulk up, may computation pa rin kung gaano karaming protein kailangan mo per body weight eh, para mag-bulk up eh. So, goals talaga. Depende sa goals mo, sa supplementation.
Noted. Yeah. Thank you, Dr. Tiger. Mm-hmm. Thank you, Edwin Clemente, for asking that question. Si Edwin mm-hmm. Clemente is an ultramarathoner. He's a mile of finisher.
Ilang beses na nakalo.
He's really a great runner. Thank you, Edwin, for asking. And he's also a Cell Life user. Yung next question for Dr. Tiger, what is your take for deep tissue massage? Dr. Tiger, kanino ba siya galing? Galing sa estudyante mo, si Brian Michael Briones.
Kinala ko nga yan.
Paano, how do you fit your exercise or training routine in a very busy workplace or workload? I'm sorry, Brian is a medical student. So, estudyante mo to, busy workload daw. So, how do you find it?
Ano ba yung tanong? Yung sa deep tissue massage or yung sa...
Wala kasing pangalan itong isa. Si Brian Leonis is asking Dr. Tiger, how do you exercise or training routine in a very busy workload?
Baka kasi masyadong preachy yung dating ko eh. So, just to put things straight talaga. Kung nakita niyo yung presentation ko, obviously, nung medyo mas bata-bata pa ako, hindi ko kaya gawin. Hindi ko kayang gawin na ipagsabay ang busy schedule sa exercising kasi kita niyo naman parang nagda-drop talaga yung ano ko eh, yung health ko eh. 'Di ba? Saka yung size ng chan ko medyo paiba-iba eh. So but now being older and being a bit wiser, for me ano talaga siya, it's really time management. Especially if it's not your job to do so. If you don't get paid to exercise or to look good, or you have to manage your time talaga. Like for example, med student siya, when do you find time? If you can go out of the dorm and run around the field for 30 minutes and take that 30 minutes away from Facebooking, diba? or TikToking or mga ganon. I mean, you know, you can always go back and do it when you watch those videos or whatever when you get home. Pero yung 30 minutes na yun, malaking bagay kasi pag inipon mo yun sa isang linggo, ano na yun eh, diba? 30 minutes, 1 hour, diba? That's 3.5 hours. Naka 3.5 hours ka na exercise na hindi mo sana siya magagawa kung, diba, kung medyo nahihirapan ka kasi mahirap yung exam ni Dr. Garrido, mag-aaral ka na lang, diba? Parang gano'n, imbis na mag-exercise, pero just...
For everyone's information, you're
I'm gonna find time lang, prioritize then. Kung sa tingin mo kailangan mo mag-exercise para makapag-aral ka, di mag-exercise ka muna. May mga kaibigan akong ganun, kailangan muna nila mag-basketball bago mag-aral eh. Kasi parang may mga classmates ako na parang si Cedric na parang medyo na umabot sila high level, nag-NCAA sila sa States ganun. So, parang nasa ano talaga nila na kailangan nila mag-basketball para mag-distress bago para pagdating ng studies medyo naka-concentrate na sila eh. No? So, parang ganun yung depende. Iba-iba eh. So, you find what works for you. No? Mm-hmm. If it works for you to have someone be your exercise buddy na parang, uy, pare, tara na. Ano, exercise time? Maghanap ka ng exercise buddy mo. Parang ganun. Or ako dati, nagpupunta akong gym kasi binayaran ko. So, sayang, pagka hindi ako nagpunta, may inis lang ako sa sarili ko pag nakita ko yung bill ko tapos twice lang ako nagpunta sa gym. Parang ganun. So, find ways. It's really, you find ways. However, bumili ka ng bagong medyas once a week kung tingin mo kung may new things ka, makakatulong sa'yo. I don't know. Kasi mga nagbabike, minsan para ganahan, bibili ng bagong piyesa sa bisikleta. Or, di ba? Parang ganun. Diba, Cap? Diba?
Sure he knows that. Doc, thank you for that. Yep. Hindi kasi nilagay yun sa deep tissue. Actually, overtime tayo kasi
okay lang.
Every, everybody's connected. Oh, tingnan mo, okay na coming from Dr. Tiger. So, anyway, Dr. Tiger, you mentioned about find your gym body. Ngayon, nakita ni nila yung nutrition body nila. So, thank you dun sa sponsor natin, Kessel Life. Kasi,
o nga naman.
Yung magiging nutrition body natin, Captain Brian, I send your Cell Life also, and si Ted has also his, and si Coach, I'm sorry, si Dr. Tiger has his already. Doc, balik tayo doon. Last na lang, I think. What is your take for deep tissue massage?
After training or pag may injury
I think this is after training. Yeah.
Well, ako kasi, I'm not a big fan of yung deep tissue massage for myself. Kasi hindi ako, parang nasasaktan ako masyado. So, nag-e-end up para sa akin, parang imbis na okay ako, parang mas lalong sumasakit after eh. No? So, it really depends kung sino gagawa kong PT or something. Kasi, kunwari, may mga stiff neck, minsan hindi ko pinapa deep tissue massage kasi nag-e-end up pagkatapos ng massage, parang imbis na gaganon sila, uy, lumambot na, parang magko-complain pa sila lalo na masakit. Preference yung deep tissue massage eh. Ako, mas gusto ko talaga stretching eh. Kaysa sa deep tissue massage. Kasi habang tumatanda at tumitigas ang katawan, alam mo na. So, mas kailangan ng stretching. Hindi bugbog ka na nga. Bubugbogin ka pa. So, I don't know. Preference siya for me. I don't see anything better than the other. No?
I think si Captain Brian's gonna say something.
Oh, yan?
Si Doc Tiger, completely opposite to me. Kasi I'm a really big fan of massage. So, if I don't really do stretches. I mean, I do stretching for mga 5 minutes towards the end.
Yeah.
It depends more on especially gusto mo na matulog.
Oh. Definitely. Nakakaantok talaga siya. Ako siguro wala pang 5 minutes na ginaganon likod ko, naghihilik na ako eh. So, I mean, may mga instances talaga, like even sa amin na kailangan talaga mag-release ng mga knots sa likod, mga ganun na ginagawa talaga ng mga PT namin. So, I'm not saying di siya ginagawa. I mean, ako for me, there are instances. Personally, ako hindi ko siya ginagawa. But for other people, hindi siya rule eh. Whatever works for you, kung anong okay sa'yo, kung ito ay okay sa'yo, sundan mo na lang. Di ba? Carry it until, your whole, athletic life. Okay naman yun eh. There's nothing wrong. Wala naman mali eh. Wala namang, yun?
Yeah. So, Captain Brian, nasagot ni Dr. Tiger yung wala naman daw mali. So, body sensing ba, Dr. Tiger?
Ano?
Body sensing.
Oo, parang gano'n, di ba? Kailangan na, listen to your body eh, di ba? It's all about, di ba? Kung injured ka, huwag ka muna maglalaro. Huwag kang muna tatakbo.
If you don't feel like racing, then don't race.
Don't race, di ba? Parang gano'n.
Bigay mo na lang yung race bib mo sa iba, di ba?
Parang gano'n, di ba? Kung hindi kaya, hindi kaya.
Pero si Cedric, hindi pwedeng magpa-replace yan.
Hindi pwede. Oo nga eh.
Magkagalit si Anox. Magkagalit si Mr. Estrada.
Bawal.
Bawal.
Sorry. Anyway, coming from Miss Jessa de Los Santos, sabi niya, 15 to 30 minutes is enough for a workout at home. Before or after work? ? Is 15 to 30 minutes workout after work and enough, Dr. Tiger? And would you give us at least basic full body workout routine? Ano lang, mga 15 to 30 minutes because working. So, thank you, Ms.
Well, 15, I don't know if hindi ko alam kung makakonsider mo na workout ang 15 minutes kasi usually
30 minutes parang, would you consider
pero depende kasi may mga iba yung nagsisprinting kasi kunwari gipit sa oras magsisprinting sila, 'di ba, mga ganun, or maghihit sila, mga ganun. So depende, pero ako if you have more than that, parang ibigay mo na lang yung time na yun. If sabi natin 30 minutes, 30 minutes is okay. May ibang tao nga, yung mga, like si coach, meron siyang mga pinapa-loose weight eh. Nagsa-start lang yan, minsan walking 30 minutes lang eh. Diba? Just as, you have to make sure yung heart rate.
Yeah,
you have to make sure yung heart rate mo tumaas. Kasi kung 30 minutes may ginagawa ka tapos yung heart rate mo mababa, eh hindi mababa. Exercise yan. Diba? Diba? So, di ko alam kung anong ginagawa mo. Diba? What would I recommend? Marami naman. I mean, you can do, there are a lot of compound exercises you can do. Yung ginagawa nga ni Cap kanina eh. Siguro pag ginawa.
Ang grabe naman ginagawa ni Kapte.
Oh.
Kahit yung boss ko saw the video, sabi niya, wow.
Yung ginagawa.
I showed the video to my boss who happens to be also an extreme triathlete. Eh, napawaw ko sa video
diba? Ni Kapte. Yung ginawa ni Kap kanina, dagdagan mo lang ng reps sa kanang sets yun.
Sakto talaga.
15 minutes, wasa ka na siguro nun yung heart rate mo.
Oo, as in, pawis ka na.
Oo. Oh. Diba?
Do that.
Oh. So, what would I recommend? Oh, sige. Eto, Dr. Grace, ano i-recommend ko? Magpagawa sila ng program dito kay Cap. Kung gusto nila ng 15 to 30 minute na, so na exercise.
We have a new coach in the house.
Oh, yeah.
I'm underqualified. Sorry. Actually, totally agree ako with Doc Tiger kanina. Yung kahit 30 minutes na workout every day. Because actually, I do that naman eh. 30 minutes lang. And then, I do lang 40-20 na intervals. Yung 40 seconds na you move, 20 seconds rest. 40-20 ulit, 40-20. So it depends na lang on the number of reps that you do and the kind of exercise that you do. So yung sabi nga ni Doc Tiger, yung compound workouts or yung mga dynamic na exercises, yung gumagalaw talaga yung whole body mo. Not just yung naka-isolate in like biceps lang or shoulders.
Just download mo yung Tabata na... Na, yes. Yeah, 'di ba? You rest for 20 seconds lang, ganun.
Para yung assistant doon.
Oh, 'di kasi I'm sure ginagawa nila 'yan, 20 seconds rest
lang. Effective 'yun. Diba? Effective 'yun Tabata. 3 sets. Pagod ka na 'yan.
'Di ba? Exactly, you have 6 exercises, you do Tabata, then you do 3 sets after that. Kumain ka na tapos matulog ka na. Parang ganun na 'yung labas nun eh. Kaya I mean, I think siguro yung tanong is just because they're hindi sila aware or I mean they're not so sure what to do pero wala just I mean you can ano well here's a good start naman diba just do so, that compound exercise yes ma'am
basta lang may humabol na ano na
sige lang okay lang
ano volleyball varsity yung daughter niya high school student si Miss Anne Sevre is 15 to 30 minutes hit to ha this is hit training enough, hit workout enough for a high school student who's a volleyball varsity player?
Kami kasi nung high school, no? Well, depende. Kasi nung medyo first year, medyo magaang pa. Pero nung third year, fourth year, kasi ano na eh, UAP junior na yun eh. Usually plyometrics namin would last, well, 30 minutes yung plyo namin. Which excludes cardio exercises. So, syempre, we're volleyball, so we have to work, do a lot on our yung jumps namin, vertical leap namin, mga ganun, core strengthening, which is sobrang ka... Ano pa rin yan? Babalik tayo dun sa exercises ni Cap. Gawin mo yan ng 15 minutes to ano? Oh, kasi yung plyometric exercises, you do that kahit saglit lang. Okay. For a high school student, the volleyball player.
High school student. Mm. Okay. Grabe, nag-overtime tayo kasi parang bitin pa, no? Dr. Tiger Cedric and...
Okay. Sila nga, gusto ko rin tanungin eh. That's a good, ano? I like it. Yeah. I like it.
Sure. After this live, we can still discuss, no? Kasi baka paluin na ako nung aking marketing director was calling the time. Anyway,
yeah, no problem.
Dr. Tiger, Captain Brian, Cedric, thank you so much for joining us this afternoon. I'm sure ang dami-daming natuwa. I mean, this is such, I would always say this is such a treat for everyone. This is awesome. In fact, marami kaming maraming nanonood, doon pa lang sa invite, got interested. Because, you know, sabi nga natin, thoughts don't create success. Action does. So, back to action tayo. I mean, you know, the quarantine shouldn't limit us from really going back to our physical activities that we, you know, got used to doing. Nakita naman natin si Captain Brian, he's an entrepreneur, he's an engineer, he's a pilot, ang daming niyang roles, and yet he finds time to do that. And of course, our very own Dr. Tiger is a doctor, he's an athlete, he's a philanthropist, lahat na, di ba? And si Cedric is a dad and a husband. So I think that shouldn't stop us from doing the regular routines that we do within the confines of our homes na hindi naman dapat we shouldn't find it so challenging kasi sabi nga natin, ang daming ways to do that. So, in Dr. Tiger, in closing, of course, we can discuss even after this webinar. Would you like to finally say something to everyone who's listening to you? I'm sure they enjoyed it. We're gonna have you back in next episode.
Sige lang.
Judy is also watching. She's an athlete ng masters.
Okay. Parting words. Well, I guess for me, number one, because of what's happening, be safe pa rin, no? Wag muna tayo mag-take ng chances. Yun yung parang first thing talaga. Let's be safe. Wag muna tayo magkasakit. Iwasan muna natin yan. Pangalawa, wag tayo masyadong yung switch yung mindset natin from yung parang inis na inis tayo na imbis na ganun, tingnan natin yung kinaganda ng ano natin, ng situation natin, which is, you know, we have a chance to work on other things na never natin, I mean, like, you know, we have a chance na makasama natin yung family natin more than ever before, which is siguro, I mean, hindi ko sinasabing okay na nagka-COVID, pero I mean, there are, may mga magagandang naidulot siya, no? Maraming mga webinar na nakakapag-reach out tayo sa mga taong who otherwise would not have even bothered listening, di ba? There are a lot of things na ganun. There are good things na makukuha natin from this na, you know, na hindi natin kailangan maging stuck dun sa isip na, ano ba to? Imbis na parang, okay, ito yung problema. Oh, gawa tayo ng, ano, meron tayong pwedeng gawin. Ganun lang. Parang ganito. Masaya siya. I mean, you know, I would not have met si Sed or si Cap and then, you know, find out what they're doing sa buhay nila. Yeah. And then through these webinars, you realize na may mga ibang tao na are going through the same thing. So you don't feel as lonely with your problems na marami palang may ganito na issue. Tapos itong mga ibang tao na to, may solution pala na ganyan. At least, may solution. Makakatulong ka at some point. I guess, you know, without sounding too, baka dasalan yun ako mamaya, kita, or something.
Cross to the other side of all this, no? Makakatawid din tayo.
Definitely. Yeah, definitely.
Thank you, Dr. Tiger.
Thank you, Dan. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. The guest ka namin ulit. I'm sure they're gonna request for more of this sa susunod. Captain Brian, thank you for your time. And you're a very busy person as well. So salamat for giving us time. Would you like to say anything to the Iligan friends of yours there? At saka yung mga friends mo sa Army Navy, nanonood.
Hello to my teammates. My everyone.
Maraming taga dito, taga Alabang na Army Navy.
Yeah. Yes. I'm always there sa Alabang. And then I saw nga team kayo sa country club eh, no? Di lang tayo
lagi.
Wala. Glolo ko yung signal ni Captain Brian.
Ay.
Okay na, Captain Brian. Thank you so much. I'll send you your cell life, sure. Hindi na tayo magkikita sa gym kasi bawal na mag-gym. Kasi si Dr. Tanya, hindi ko magkikita sa pool kasi bawal na rin mag-gym.
Bawal pa.
Pero magkikita pa because Cedric is my... Thank you for your time. This is basketball player, the Trap of Mapua also. Thank you.
parang thank gaganahan you. Ka kasi si Cedric pumasok sa finals tapos naka sell life eh. Parang
yes,
naganahan so. Na ako yung take eh. Maganda yung pagka-endorse ni Ced eh.
Thank you guys for having me. Such an honor to join you guys.
It's fun. Yeah.
Okay.
Thank you.
That's it. Thank you, Cedric. Next week po, our topic, ang pag-uusapan natin ay tungkol naman sa nose, throat, at malalaman po natin kung ano yung importansya ng mouth rinsing to prevent oral and viral respiratory infection. Pati na rin po yung natutulong ng alcohol as antiseptic to get rid of disease-causing viruses. Mag-iimbita po tayo ng isang ENT doctor who's gonna help us. It's another timely and interesting topic for our viewers. Just visit and like our Facebook pages, Cell Life and Oranim, Settle and Settle Active, IC, No Rash, PJC Soaps, and Nimit Clean Alcohol and Hand Sanitizer. Our company products are available at Mercury Drug, South Star Drug, Generica Drug Stores, at the Generic Pharmacy. Available din po ang ating mga produkto sa lahat ng ating authorized provincial distributors. For product inquiries, please visit our website at www.farmaciajimenez.com or call us at 866-1-8071. We will see you again Saturday next week via FB Live for another episode of Nutrition and Health Webinar Series. Magandang hapon po sa inyong lahat and thank you! Thank you.